talk about music for you and where it comes into your process, and if it's written, are pieces written into the script? You know, was I Want Candy written into the script?
I think it was. I remember there's some lesson they tell you, like, never write it in the script, because then they'll try to it'll cost too much because they'll know you need it in there. But I definitely have pieces of music in mind for certain sequences, and I know that's the fun part. I've always loved music and going to concerts when I was younger. So even when I did my first short, like, part of putting the music together makes it kind of come alive and have energy. And and it conveys so much of the feeling. But so I've always, as I write, I'm listening to music. And when I was writing Virgin Suicides, I was listening to Ayers' first album. And that's when I thought, oh, maybe I could ask them to do the music for it, because it felt like this. I wanted the film to be a memory, not set in the 70s. So how to use contemporary music to feel like this kind of dreamy memory feeling about it. So I think about the music and the visuals early on, and that kind of informs the tone, so all of my team we can all be on the same page of what the feeling is. And I even give music to the actors, and we play music on set. And like in Wild, I wanted to really be sparse, intense, and the lack of music, I think, gave a different feeling. And I also think in the editing room, Sarah Flack, the editor I always work with, who I love, we always try to cut the scenes without music and make it work, because I think whenever you put music on, it always makes the scene better. So I think that would be something I would just pass on as a good habit, to make your scene work without music, because it can be used kind of as a crutch too.